What are you doing?
You're not doing anything. Stay over there. No, no, I'm going. I'm going. Stop. One, two.
To do it this way.
Okay. Let me do it.
Do it sideways. One. So the world can see you.
Hello. It's me editing this video right now, but I feel like I should put a little bit of like context in just because I filmed a lot without talking. So after I got everything set up, made my little station on the balcony, my little art studio, which is actually still out there. Day one, I had like 7 canvases in the pack. So I basically just made one as like my practice. I'm gonna just go for it on this canvas and figure out all the trial and errors. And let me tell you, there was a lot that I learned throughout this process of things that I will do differently the next time that I try to do this type of like art. But day one, I kind of just like went at it on the canvas and this is what I came up with. I was definitely trying to go for that like pour over style art where you've seen it on Facebook where people have like a canvas and they take cups and they pour different colors on it and then it like drips everywhere and it looks really like marbly and cool and all that. But I do know that there are different types of like mixing mediums that people are mixing in with acrylic paint to get it to like be drippy like that, and I didn't have that. I basically was just like going at it on the canvas, like kind of just pouring paint on it, and then I would hold it in different directions to get it to like drip different ways, and then I would let that dry completely and then go back at it either the same day or the next day and add more drips on it and more paint to it and just layer that on top. I am surprised that these canvases did not deteriorate because I put so much paint on this. Those are definitely things that next time I'll be more aware of, is getting a better canvas and adding a mixing medium into the paint so that it drips over more easily. Paints that I got were 50 cents each from Walmart, so they weren't expensive, and I knew that I could always run back to Walmart and get more of the same color if I ran out of paint. But what I was doing to kind of help save paint in the meantime was every time I would hold up a canvas and have the paint be dripping, I would hold it over another canvas and get drips on that canvas because I wanted these to look as messy as possible. I was kind of going for like a drippy, spilling like gum wall type of vibe. I wanted it to just be as messy as possible and as random with random little drips and dots and things on it. So I would always just hold it over a canvas and get, you know, some paint on the next canvas and not waste it. And it worked out pretty good actually. I did have a decent amount of paint on the canvases before I would go ahead and start the next one. And then just to add more to the paintings, since there was a lot of dripping and there wasn't too much else happening, I kind of figured out how I could do splatter paint. And basically how I did that was with a cup and a brush, and I would get paint all over the brush, or I would put the paint on the inside of the cup close to the rim, close to the top of the cup, and then I would just take my paintbrush and just like I go against the cup and direct it towards the painting, and it was splattering everywhere and it was doing exactly what I wanted it to do. And then I was also taking my brush and kind of just like going over some of the drips and just kind of making the shapes a little bit cooler and a little bit less like dripping splatter paint art, and a little bit more like art. So yeah, here's some clips from that. And this is taken over the course of like a week. I worked on these for like a solid week straight, and I would just go out there every day for like 2 hours and just add more and more and more and more and more on top of these canvases until they were what I considered done.
Okay, so these are the canvases all done. I still haven't really figured out like if I want to put them the horizontal way or the vertical way or what. I haven't gotten that far, but they are done. I sprayed them with the varnish. They're all good to go. I also bought these like smaller canvases, and I think I'm gonna put these in my bathroom, but I think I'm gonna do it like upside down. Yeah, like that. I'm in our room. It is quite a mess right now, but I'm just gonna deal with that later. I'm gonna hang up the pictures and surprise Taylor. I'm super excited. We have like no art in here except for this tapestry. This one is like velvety. Love it. This is like in my little corner where my shoes are here. But right now, I'm gonna hang up the paintings that I just made in the bed right there above the pillows. Oh, it's so cute. They're not as big as I thought, but there's four of them, so. Cute. All right, one more. I'm not bad. And hanging shit up. You don't need a boyfriend. You don't need a level, first of all. You don't need a man. You don't need a woman. You don't need a parent. You don't need a dad. That's sure as hell. You can do this by yourself. I just like holding the hammer. It's heavy. I feel like it's gonna fly out of my hand and could probably kill someone. I feel powerful. And that looks good. They look so good. Oh, proud moment. My baby's getting hung up. It looks really good. Okay, it looks so freaking cute in here. Wow, I love it. I love it. I freaking love it. Look at that.
Okay, I have a surprise for you.
Oh my God! And you did it.
We run when we start to see her.